Welcome to One Chemistry. Always do your best. Now, let us see about 100 conversion in organic chemistry. This is the 29th episode. If you didn't watch previous episode, I encourage you to go and see. Here, we solve 5 problems step by step. Stay tuned. Let us see the question number 1. The starting metal is 6-member linear system with ketone, methyl and alkene in there. Here you are using the light. They ask you to predict the product. They given 4 choices. Among that, they ask you to find which 2 of it is the plausible product. Here you have to understand that one naming reaction is involved and you have to analyze the possible products. The answer is D. Let us see how. The starting metal in the system which is appropriate for the Norris type 2 reaction because it have gamma hydrogen and carbonyl group, so definitely there can be the possibility. So here we written alpha and beta, gamma hydrogen also written near to the oxygen. So the proximity, the hydrogen transfer occurs. So the di radical remains there. So the di radical forms. The di radicals, the 1 and 4 connects form the 4-member system. If you go by the usual formula, you will end up with A. So we rewrite to the square 1 and obviously the choice is A. Suppose the di radical goes to the intermediate pathway, which means that double bond gets di radical again and the double bond again formed between 1 and 2. The 1 and 2 double bond is formed there. Again the 5th position and 4th position the radical is there. So the how the radicals are combined? The 5th position and 4th position have to be quenched, so both are bond and CC linkage is occurred. So the new bond between 5 and 4. So the ring is closed, you get again 4-member cyclic system. But here is a different one with 2 methyl group. The choice is B there. So the answer contain A and B, so the choice is D. Here you have to learn 2 things. One is there is a gamma hydrogen with carbonyl group in definitely Norris type 2 reaction. And the intermediate has the possibility of extend itself through the alkene or any strain system. Then the question number 2. The starting metal is the dicarboxylic acid. The product is the closed one with ketone and alcohol inside. Here the choices are given for the reagents, which is sodium methylene and trimethylsilyl chloride and water, or titanium chloride, zinc chloride or trimethylsilyl chloride. Here you have to find the reagent for this conversion. From the question you have to understand that the ring closure is definitely occurred there and one naming reaction is involved. The answer is A. Let us see how. This is the acyline condensation which occurred internally because you have ester, you are using the sodium and xylene. So sodium and xylene you are using. So the kind of radical oxidation there. So the oxidation occurs, the di radical is formed. The radicals are vibrant, tend to form the bond. So the bond formation occurs. So the 4-member cyclic ring occurs there. Here you are using the trimethylsilyl chloride, which is a very important one because it abstracts the methoxy radical. So the methoxy radical have to be leave. So the bond formation between C and O happened. So C double bond O formed on both ends. So again we are using sodium and xylene there. So sodium and xylene di radical is formed again. So the double bond formation between carbon and carbon there inside the ring. So the double bond formed there. Again the radical is on the hanging. Then we are using the water, it become hydroxy group. So both radical become hydroxy group. At last OH attached with double bond leads to ketoenol tautomerism. So it leads to the defined answer. Here you have to learn 2 important things. One is acyline condensation, how it occurs and which pathway it will move. One more thing you have to know that trimethylsilyl chloride is thirst for oxygen, so it abstracts the methoxy radical from the system, which is the major driving force for ketone formation. Then the question number 3. The starting metal is cyclohexanone. You are using the azide and trifluoroacetic acid. Here the choices are given. Just a amine formation or the ring expansion or the cyclic system or fused system is forming there. Here you have to understand that one naming reaction is involved and ring expansion possibility. The reaction is very simple. It is a cartilage rearrangement, but it's occurred in the cyclic system. So you need to know the mechanism very well. Here we rewritten the aside. The negative charge on the nitrogen attacks the carbonyl carbon. It is a nucleophilic attack on carbon. So the carbonyl group opens and O minus is there. Here everybody knows nitrogen is the leaving group. Then you are using the trifluoroacetic acid, the acid donated there. The system is vibrant because of the nitrogen leaving group. So the sixth carbon or methylene carbon moved to the nitrogen, which is in the seventh position. So the ring expands there. So the ring expanded. The carbocation formed in the first position because we are breaking the ring, right? So ring opened, the positive charge is there. The positive charge only quenched by the hydrogen leaving. So the positive charge quenched as heat on. Then the question number 4. The starting middle is anthracnic acid. Then you are using the amyl nitrate. Here amyl nitrate is there, NO group is there. They ask you to find the product, which one is formed. Here the products are very complicated, but if you understand the reaction very well, it's a simple reaction with a stable intermediate. The answer is A. Let us see how. Here amyl nitrate is given for the confusion, because amyl nitrate is the big reagent. It only involved in the diacetization. So NH2 become N2+. Here diacetization doesn't involve any CC coupling, so it doesn't involve or coming into the play. So just a azide formation. Then the azide is there, then the O minus is there. So O minus has to be quenched and positive charge also has to be quenched. So what happened? N2 and CO2 are good leaving group. They leaves from the stable intermediate. Here driving force is benzene formation. So the nitrogen and CO2 leaves. So the benzene is there. There is a possibility of dimerization, because benzene is very much unstable when compared to the normal system. Hence the dimerization occurs. So the dimer coupling is occurred. So the kind of middle Cuban kind of ring formation occurred. Here you have to learn two things. Amyl nitrate didn't play any role, only involved in the diacetization. If there is a good leaving group in the ortho position, both leaves form the benzene. Then the question number 5. The question number 5, starting middle is a carboxylic acid and the reagents are like formic system with methoxyl and chlorine on the other side. Then we are using the cyclohexylamine. Here we are using the base triethylamine. Here various charges are given where the amine is attacked. Basically you have to find where the amine attacks, how the ring formation or carbon-carbon formation occurs there. You also have to find the possibility of cyclic ring formation. Here you have to understand that which group leaves and the selectivity of NU- or nucleophile. The answer is A. Let us see how. The question is very simple. It demands your understanding on basics. It's very simple which one is attack on which. Here you are using the base triethylamine and you are using the acid. So the proton abstraction occurs there. So the negative charge form and the negative charge can attack on the carbonyl. So the carbonyl double bond breaks and O minus is formed. The O minus has to be stabilized. Here the competition comes, which groups leave. Methoxy group leave or chlorine will leave. Normally the weak bases of strong acid leaves much better. So the chlorine is the stronger acid, HCl, and it's a weak base there. So methanol is a weak acid, so conjugate base is stronger. So the chlorine leaves, form the esters there. The next step, you are using the cyclohexylamine, where the amine will attack NH2 or COO group there. But the only attack on the phenyl carbonyl system, because methoxy group can donate the lone pair of electron, weakening the nucleophilicity of carbonyl. So the resonance destroy the positive charge on the carbon. So the only active carbon is the phenyl carbon. So the amine attacks on the carbonyl, the carbonyl bond opens again. Then to have the stability, the other part leaves. The final product is a condensed amine system. It's basically amide. So the clearly answer is A. Here you have to learn two things. One is the better leaving group always have lowest basicity or conjugated strong acid. If there is a competition between ester and carbonyl, always the carbonyl wins because of the resonance involved in the methoxy system. That's all from this episode. I hope it was useful. Thanks for watching. If you have any suggestion, comment below. Stay tuned for next episode.